Hi, and welcome to the EventLearning channel. If you're new here, this channel is all about GrandMA3. I try to teach you how you can use the console and how you can use different aspects of the GrandMA3 software. If you have been to the channel before, welcome back. I know it's been quite a while since my last video, and since 2.2 just dropped yesterday, I'm just gonna go into making a few tutorials on that piece of software. And in this software, or in this tutorial, or whatever you wanna call it, it's gonna be about the recipe editor, which I think is amazing, and I'm really gonna use that. I know there's been some plugins out there which work in a similar fashion. Now MA implemented it into the GrandMA3 software itself, which I find really, really cool. So let's just get right into it. You can see I prepared a small show here. I have some groups up here. I have a lot of different presets. I have some faces, some predefined faces, some MATricks, just one single sequence, which you can see over here, and then my 3D view over here. And to get into the recipe editor, we simply need to open it up as a window, as any other window, basically. So we simply just drag it out here and we go into tools, and you can find it here, the recipe editor. And as soon as that is open, we can start editing recipes. Right now it's not active, and you can see that if you look at the groups and the presets over here, they look like they normally do. If you press this button, edit recipe, you can see they change into a pot symbol, which is the recipe symbol. So what we can basically do is just start programming a song here. I just predefined a lot of stuff here, so let's just go up into queue number one, so we're ready for putting some stuff into it. So first of all, we take our auras, we turn them on, and you can see it automatically generates a recipe line here for the auras. Let's just make this a little bit smaller so we can see what's going on. You can see the selection is the auras, and the preset is just dimmer at full. So the next one is to put them into a position like this. And the next thing is to give it a color. So now we have three different recipe lines for this first queue. So we can store this into queue number one. We say store queue one and merge. And now we are ready to continue with the next queue. In the next queue, I would like my Mac Ultras to turn on with a gobo in it. So to set that up, I'll just do that in the first queue. Take our Ultras here and just put in a gobo and put them into one of the positions I have here. And then I can store this into Q1 so they are ready for being turned on in queue number two. So let's go into queue number two and just take our Ultras here, oops, like this, and turn them on. And you can see we now turned them on. Let's store this into queue number two and merge it. What you can do is you can select something and you can select a position somewhere. And you can see right now I've actually selected two, now three different positions, and it makes a recipe line for each different one. And we don't want that, so we can basically go in and deselect them again, and then they go away, which is really cool. You have to notice when this happens, and there's also a way we can fix it if something happened. But right now we are in song number two, they turned on. Let's just go into queue number three here, into our verse, and take our Ultras and move them up into the air. You can see I have two recipe lines now. I only need one, so I remove the first one and I store this into queue number three. So basically we have three different queues now. The first one, we just turn them on. The next one, we turn on the Ultras. And the next one, we move them up into the air. In queue number four, I need to turn my Fortes on. I would like them to be set with a gobo in the correct position from the previous queue, the one we're in now. So I can just deselect this stuff, select the Fortes, put them in the floor position, give them a gobo, and you can see once again, they automatically generate the recipe lines. So let's store this into queue number three and merge, and they are ready to be turned on in the next queue. So let's go to the next queue, clear everything, and take all our Fortes here, just turn them on, and store this into queue number four. So everything right now is happening with a zero time. So basically, we could give it some timing. So the first one is okay. The next one, let's see what happens here. We turn those on. We can give it a fade time of one, like this. the verse, what's happening here. They move up. Let's just give this a fade time of 6 seconds. And then the chorus, we have these guys turning on, and we already have that at 3 seconds. So the timings work like you are used to. You can also go in and do the timing directly in the recipe line, and I'll get back to that in a second, because now we're gonna need a break here. And you can see I have two cues. The first cue, I want my blinders to turn on, but I want it to turn on from the left to right. And then in the follow, the automatically time cue, I need them to turn off, so we basically just get like a swipe from one side to the other. So let's go into the two cues here. Let's see, we are in the break cue here, and we need to activate our blinders at full. And what we can do is we can delay it here from 0 to 1 second. And if you go in and just look at a MA trick like this, it's very simple, just a predefined MA trick. And you can just press it like this, activate it, and that should put the timing into the recipe line itself. So if we store this into the first break cue here, and then we clear this stuff and we take the blinders again, turn it off, use the same delay, and store this into cue number 6, like this. Now we basically should get a swipe from one side to the other. So if we go through our sequence again, we are ready here with our blinders. And as soon as they've done their movement, we can activate the next cue. And you can see they go from one side to the other, simply using MATricks. Let's say we go into the verse now, and we need some more action to happen. We can take our ultras here, and we can actually point them directly to a circle. And then gonna start like a predefined circle. They're just doing the same exact thing, which is not what we want. We want it to be somehow shuffled or something like that. And for that, I made another MA trick here, and I'm just gonna show you. It gives it a wing of 2. It faces from 0 to 360, and it turns on the transform into the mirror mode. So as soon as I activate this one, it's gonna do what I ask it to do. And once again, if we look at the recipe line, you can see it does the face here. It gives it a wing of 2, and it actually makes the transition into a mirror. So if we store this into cue number 7, we should basically have everything we need. So the next cue, I know I call it chorus, but I just want to show you how we can use our strobes and use our generators using the recipe editor as well. So if we go into our strike M's here, we give it a position, and we can basically store the position in the previous cue just to make sure that it tracks along and are ready down here in cue number 8. So we take our strike M's and we just turn on our random generator here, and they start flashing randomly because I predefined a random generator earlier on. And also, you can see up here, it's also simply just put into a recipe line. When you see this orange color, that means that the preset is only partially used. It's not a problem if you are watching exactly what you want on screen. Just know that if it turns orange, it's not necessarily a problem. It's only because some of the fixtures are only partly used in this cue. And that's probably because the Strike M's has different cells of strobe, and I only use one of them. So this is basically what happens in cue number 8. Let's store this into cue number 8, like this. And now let's try to do something which we don't want to do, basically. So we go into the last cue and we clear everything here. And now we take our ultras and auras, and we give them white, and we give them yellow, and we give them all different kinds of colors, like this. The problem is that we make a recipe line for everything, and we basically don't need to do that. And as I showed you before, you can actually deselect everything, but sometimes you might by accident record something which you don't need. So let's just clear this and go into the ultras again. Let's give it all kinds of different colors like this, and store this into the last cue like this. We merge it in, and now you can see all this information which we don't need. So what can we do about it? We could technically just go in and delete from the top to the bottom except for the last one, because it tracks from the top to the bottom. So it's only the last one which is active. But what we can do instead is go in to our command section, and we can say, edit the queue, please. And if you look over here on the screen, we now have everything loaded into the programmer. We can turn on edit recipe, and you can see this cleanup button right here. And if I push the cleanup button, it should remove everything but what is active. So this is one way you can get out of it. The console can actually help you. It's kind of unblocking a queue where you remove information which is not necessary. Well, it's the same principle anyway. So this is basically how the recipe editor works. You can combine different presets, MATricks, faces. You can actually use worlds and filters and stuff like that using your MATricks as well. It's very simple to use. When you activate it, you simply just click this button up here. You can also click MA and edit. That will put edit recipe into the command line, and you press please, and that's going to activate it as well. You can use macros and stuff like that to activate it, but it's actually very, very cool to work with and very simple. So I hope you enjoyed this video on event lighting, and I'm glad to see you back here if you have been here before. And I hope you're going to play with this at home. And if you do, I wish you happy programming on your GrandMA3 software. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.